Amaya and I are talking in a bed of mullica queens in mid-July, and I'm seeing some uprights are already putting on a lot of color, and others are still pretty well just green. Amaya, can you tell me what is contributing to the color development on this upright?
Absolutely. The main two factors that affect color development on cranberries are light interception. We need light for inducing that color development, but also cold nights. That's why we always wait for harvest for those cool nights that will stimulate the development of color. However, for that to work, we really need to have really good light interception. So you can see already here these berries that are on the top uprights. They are changing colors because they are constantly during the day receiving that light and that UV light that is developing this color. And the reason why this develops is because it's a way to protect the vines. These red anthocyanins that are developing are protecting, they're working almost like a sunscreen. That's what they're doing right now. So if we want to have good color development for harvest, one of the things that is crucial is how we maintain our canopy management. And you can see specifically in this bed, there's a lot of runners, a lot of vigor, vegetative vigor. And what's gonna happen is a lot of the berries are gonna be downed and they're not gonna be receiving this light. They're not gonna intercept this light, which means that it's gonna take them longer in the fall to develop the color. What can we do to control vegetative vigor so that we have all of our berries exposed and we have good color development in the fall? Nitrogen fertilization will encourage a lot of vegetative growth. If we have a bed that is on peat and there's a lot of release of nitrogen, it's really important also to control the additional fertilizer that we're applying. Irrigation, a lot of irrigation would also stimulate more vegetative growth.
So in the old days, I hear about people talking about taking clippers through and clipping off the top vegetative layer of growth. That sounds a lot more wasteful than just applying less fertilizer to start with.
Absolutely. Having to come here and do all of that extra work, you, first of all, can damage the developing berries by doing that.
But it's
so much wasted time and effort and labor in having to clip that, when a good solution for this would be just to reduce especially nitrogen fertilizer for the following year so that we can have less of this vegetative growth. Mm-hmm.